Welcome back, baseball fans, to the 76, 77, 78, 79 carryover league. Fall league. And we have another game between... We got the Braves and Giants today. First two games were in Atlanta, and the Braves won them both. Giants need to win this game to force a game four and hopefully get a split. If the Braves win the first three games, the series is over, because I don't want the Braves to win four games against the Giants. I don't want the Giants to lose four games to the Braves. To kind of tilt the overall season, which is basically built around divisional play and not league play, if possible. One and if possible. Today's starting pitchers for the Braves, Andy Messersmith. You may recall him playing for the Angels in 69 in the Summer League. And we have... For the Giants, it'll be their number four starter, John Uria. We're just going to get started here. Kind of go through some seeing new faces and new places. Gary Matthews leads off for the Braves. 66 is Skies of Center. Bob Stinson, double and a four, double. Barry Bonnell, 1-7, is a base at the left field. The Braves are picking up where they left off at Atlanta. Yeah, runners in the corners. John Mayberry. I don't know how he ended up leaving Kansas City so soon, but he did. 58. Bounces to short. Didn't even go to Toronto. 334. You know, the two drafts, that's a ground ball B scores a run. The two leagues, the summer and fall league, are independent of each other. So there's not a reliance on, you know, and there are... There's usually 4 years in between. So I just wrapped up 84, 69, 70, 71, right? Then there's a four-year gap, 72, 73, 74, 75. Then this league is 76, 77, 78, 79. And then there's another four-year gap of 80, 81, 82, 83, until, again, you get that loop going. So it's a 16-year loop from 1969 to 1984. So you stage the two leagues as far apart as you can so they don't overlap. But think of it like a four-year Olympic, like the summer-winter summer-winter Olympics or something bizarre like that. So, Rico Cardi now, 47. That's going to be a base hit. And with two outs and two on, it's Rupert Jones, Nikkei's. All right, bottom of the first. Darryl Evans, 55, walks. Ron Pruitt, 57 Ks. Tom Hutton, 38. Single one of nine is a single. Two on, one out. Jack Clark. We just saw him in his 84 card. This is his 1978 card. Let's take a look at that, by the way. That's a 78 Jack Clark card. He strikes out with it, though. And McCovey, 2-7 single. The bases are loaded. Two outs for Mike Ivey, who's playing second base today, folks. Let's take a look at the card. And Mike Ivey didn't play second base, but he did on this particular year. And the Giants are playing him there just to get extra bats in the lineup. You know, that's okay, Giants. I'm fine with that. I prefer not to be, you know, changing the spirit of the game a bit. You know, Ivy really should be a first baseman, but do what you wish. And 68, Ivy pops to third. All right. We go to the second inning. Davey Johnson. Now, we know he went to Atlanta from the Orioles, had 40-some-odd homers. He actually, this card, let's take a look at this Davey Johnson card. This is actually with the Phillies in 77. So, nice card. Anyway, he strikes out. Jerry Royster, 64, short X. I think he was a lifetime Brave, or mostly with the Braves. And Mike Phillips, kind of one of those, always in the league because he bats left-handed middle infielder guys. Grounds a second. All right. Bum of two, Terry Whitfield, 38. Let's base it. Johnny LeMaster, 43, first X. The master is, once he gets power, I think by 1970 or 1980, 81, 82, one of those years, he'll end up on the Colorado Rockies in a trade, just because the Rockies like power at every position. And there wasn't a lot of shortstops who had power at the time. And it was a rare year where LeMaster had power. And yeah, but for right now, he is still a member of the Giants. And he hits a ground ball to the 2E8 at first base, Mayberry, 2E8. That's a double play. Mark Hill, 46. Triple 1-2, flies left. Top of the third, Gary Matthews, 52, pitcher. Bob Stinson, 56, second X. That's second base, a 4E41. And he makes an error. Well, that sounds about right. Bunnell, K's. Mayberry, flies center. Bottom of third. Darrell Evans, 1-5, flies right. Ron Pruitt, left. Tom Hutton, 52, pitcher. We'll go to the fourth, 1-0 game. Rico Cardi, yeah, he was with the Braves for a big chunk of the early part of the decade. He did end up playing a little bit for Cleveland. He does play a little bit for Oakland. This is his 78. Let's take a look at this one. This is the 78 Oakland A card with 31 home runs. 45's a double. Rupert Jones, 55's a walk. Davey Johnson, left. And with two outs, Rupert Jones, or one out, Rupert Jones, Jerry Royster remain. Jerry Royster, 35. Double 1-3 is a single, dot, dot. We have a 2-0 game. Runners on the corners, one out. We'll bring it up for Phillips. He caves. Two outs. Matthews. 6-11. Bounces to second. This is the... Oh, he makes a ground ball B this time. 2-0. Jack Lark, 4-11. Left. Matthews, 4-11. That's a base hit. McCovey, 64. Short X. Phillips is a 4E27. That's another single. Bad defense on the Braves. Ivy, 2-6. We saw the car earlier. Triple 1-2. Single. Single dot dot. Giants on the board. 2-1. Playing back for Whitfield. Right the question mark from McCovey. No, he's not going to run. LeMaster, I'll bring it up with one out. 1-8. Triple 1. Single dot dot. We got a tie game at 2. Up and hold for Mark Hill. Second C. We're in our second and third. Two outs for Darrell Evans. That was the first. Stinson, 69, center. Bunnell, 111, third. Mayberry, 1-5, walks. Cardi, 55, bounces to short. This is the 3-34 LeMaster, and he makes the play. 2-2 in the fifth. Giants need this win. Ron Pruitt, 3-10, left. Hutton, 2-7, single. Jack Clark, 37K. And McCovey, 54. Center C. You know, another thing here with these two teams, the Braves and Giants, just a quick little commentary about these two teams, is that because the Cincinnati Reds went out of the National League West into the National League North, and the Braves also left for greener pastures, they went to the National League East. It really made their fortunes potentially easier because the Braves don't have to face the Reds, Dodgers, and Giants. And the Giants are glad to see two of their tenants in their building move out, and it's just really the Giants and Dodgers out west. The 1970s, you know, the Braves would always have a powder keg of offense. They still have it, really. And, they could... If they get decent pitching, the Braves can, you know, be a steady player in the National League East for the whole decade. Mm-hmm. Giants had a lean period, but they did have guys coming up in their system. They had Gary Maddox and they had Gary Matthews. Well, here already, one of their guys that came up through their system, Gary Matthews, is on the Braves of all team. Gary Maddox is on Philadelphia. And somehow I think Tom Hutton left Philadelphia to come to the Giants in that deal. But with Jack Clark, with a late in his career Willie McCovey having a comeback of the year kind of season, and with the Ivy crushing balls. Really, the Giants and the Braves are going to have much, they'll be much more happier in this era than they originally were. So the future is bright for these two teams, regardless of what happens today in this game. So here we go. Rupert Jones in the sixth inning. 55's a walk. He's a beast stealer. Zero arm hill. Davey Johnson's going to hit away. 58, sky to left. Royster, 2-6, short. Ace stealing Royster with two outs will steal a base, and he steals. And Hill's T is 1-6. So we have runner at second with two outs from Mike Phillips. He strikes out. All right, bottom of the sixth, Mike Ivey bounces to second. This is Royster, 2E32. Whitfield, 69, second. LeMaster, 57, K's. We go to the seventh inning. Matthews, 57, 2-2, K. Stinson, 53, right X. Jack Clarkson, right, he's a 3-7. Makes the grab. Bunnell, 48, single to 19 is a single, barely, off Uria. And with two outs, Mayberry. 1-9, let's look at John Mayberry's card. This is the 79, already on Toronto Blue Jay John Mayberry. So, not sure how I made that transaction happen. I can't recall how this draft went. I'm guessing Toronto already had another first baseman, and Mayberry was on Kansas City. So the Braves were looking for a left-handed stick at first, and that's how he got to the Braves. That's my guess, but there's no need to go through all the transactions to figure out how that happened. It's going to be a double, and does Bunnell want to run all the way from first? He's a 14-15-16 against the zero-armer Whitfield to give the Braves a lead in the seventh, and he rolls an 8 and scores. So a big play there, and the Braves grab a 3-2 lead. Rico Cardi bounces to second. Again, this is Ivy. He is at 40-41, but he makes the play. Okay. We have a 3-2 game in the seventh inning stretch. Party Down, background music by Little Beaver, 1974. Get into the party life. That's right, folks. Get into it. Okay, we're back. Bottom of the seventh. 3-2 game, Messersmith starter 8. Braves want a sweep. That could be very important in this league. They're contending with the Mets, Phillies, and, well, Phillies at the height of their power, Mets and Florida. It's the Phillies you have to worry about in this that division, with Luzinski and Schmidt and all that, Carlton. Mark Hill, 110. A leadoff single for Messersmith. He's not going anywhere. It's going to be Darrell Evans. 2-3, pop out. You're going to have to break Messersmith to get him out of there, and he's a starter 8. Pruitt, 4-10. Center X. Center's Rupert Jones, a 2-E9 in center field. Makes the grab, and with two outs, it's Tom E.F. Hutton. 55's a walk. Two on, two outs. Here it is. Jack Clark, big play here. Bottom of the seventh. The pitch, 49. Clark walks. Starter 8, not broken. Pitching coach comes out to settle him down, but they're not going to hook him. And it's Willie McCovey. So let's take a look at McCovey here. It's been, there were some lean years in there for him. He's back with the Giants in 1977 after the exodus to San Diego, which had some good years, some good, some bad. He had a really crappy 76, I believe. But here he is, bases loaded, two outs. Against Messersmith. The pitch. 2-6, he comes through with a base hit in the left field. This will be Hutton. And he's a 12, 13, 14, plus one arm of Gary Matthews. And he scores an 11, a big two-out single. And Messersmith's dejected now. Jack Clark's a pretty good runner, I guess. Yeah, he goes to third. You have runners on the corners, two outs for Mike Ivey. You definitely don't want to have a lefty in here. So Messersmith sticks around. Ivey, 37. It's a strikeout. All right, so the lead changes hands in the seventh. What a great game we got. And you know what? Let's take Ivey, Uria out. let's get into this vaunted Giants bullpen. We got Gary Lavelle and Randy Moffitt at the end of it. So here's Lavelle. Pretty much your standard Gary Lavelle of this era. It doesn't really matter which year. He's always a good guy. Sometimes he's more nastier against lefties than others, but otherwise, he's always a consistent guy against lefties and righties, a guy you can rely on for the Giants. So we go to the eighth, and it'll be Rupert Jones, who has power, so he's going to stick around to face Lavelle. 54, bounces to third. Evans is a 4, but he's an E5. So in there for his E rating at third base, and he makes the play. Dave Johnson, 49, center. And with two outs, Royster, 2-5, short. All right, 4-3 game. I'm not really crazy about Atlanta's bullpen at all. So Matt Smith's going to actually stay out there in his breaking inning. Whitfield, 66, center. LeMaster, 412, left. And Mark Hill, 47, double and 11, fly ball, double. And with two outs, it's Darrell Evans. 36, guys, all right. One of the other things about Ivy playing second base is that they have no other defensive second baseman other than Rob Sparing. And Tom Hutton is a 1-11 at first base, so that has something to factor into it. And they're not even going to bother with a defensive. Neither team really boasts very good defense. So it's the ninth inning. Lavelle against Mike Phillips. And the thing is here, the... Yeah, they will actually bat for Phillips here. It'll be Eli Rodriguez. Good on-base guy. E-Rod. The original E-Rod is up against Lavelle. And here's the pitch to the pinch hitter. 48, sky's the center. Gary Matthews, and then Stinson candidate lefty, so a pinch hitter. So, now he'll pitch to him, Gary Matthews. 53 off Lavelle, flies in a left. Left field's Pruitt is a 3-8, and he makes the grab. So it's two outs in the ninth inning, and now you got them where you want them, because if you go to the bench, they'll go to the bullpen. It's the situation you want. So they're going to go with Leroy Stanton and go for a possible tie. Let's take a look at Leroy Stanton's card. And Lavelle will obviously leave here. No reason to... Not when you have your Giant closer, Randy Motief. Randy Moffitt. Comes on in the ninth. Take a look at his card. It's the Leroy Stanton card in the ninth inning. Two outs, nobody on base. They're looking for that home run to tie the game. Leroy Stanton, the pitch. 63 off Moffitt. It's a ground ball to second. This is Ivy. He's a 4-41. And that's how games don't end. An error. Stanton's a 1-12 runner. That's good to know. Now you got Barry Bonnell, who's actually better against righties than lefties. Let's take a look at his card. Bonnell hit 300 with his card. This is the 77 Bonnell card. You can tell he's got the 1-5-10 card, which means he led the Braves in hitting in 1977. So Bonnell with a runner at first, two outs in the ninth inning, 48 off of Moffitt is a walk, and it's getting exciting now. And this is all the Braves wanted. They wanted Mayberry. And Giants have to pitch to this guy. They could bring in Laxton. But Moffitt's the closer. Percentages say bring in setup guy Bill Laxton here, but they're not. They're going to pitch this guy in the ninth inning, 4-3 game, John Mayberry versus Randy Moffitt. He's got a double and a walk in four trips. The pitch to Mayberry in the ninth inning, 1-9! Well, folks, it's triple 1-5 single against lefties, which would tie the game. In this instance, it's homer 1-13 double. You saw the card earlier, and that's going to be a double to tie the game. But Bonnell is circling third. He's a good 14, 15, 16 against the Whitfield arm in center field. And he rolls a 16. He slides in safe at the plate. Wow, even a regular season game's exciting, huh? So the move was, you don't want Mayberry to bat versus a righty in the ninth. The Giants did not figure that one out, and because of that, they are now losing on a two-out, two-run double by John Mayberry. And now you got Rico Cardi. 2-7, Rico Cardi, base hit in the center. And Mayberry won't run. And it's Randy Moffitt against Rupert Jones. Runners in the corners, two outs in the ninth inning. 3-6 is a K. So, bunch of lead changes late in this game. Never a dull moment around here, folks. 5-4 Braves in the ninth, and this time I am going to lift Messersmith and not have him get involved in this ninth inning. I just kind of want to give the Giants a chance to redeem themselves. So the Braves are going to bring their closer in. His name is Dave Campbell. He had a pretty good 1977. He had a 3.03 ERA. He was 0-6, but don't let that fool you, folks, because he was their finisher, for what that is worth. Again, the Braves did not have a lot of success in this decade, and they want to correct that right now. So, in the ninth inning, it will be Dave Campbell, and it'll be Ron Pruitt leading off for the Giants. 67 is a K. Tom Hutton, 55 is the walk. Tie run at first for Jack Clark. Pitch to Clark, 32. Short B plus. And no holding there, he's a D. Clark has to be held though, he's a B. So he's being held on at first for Willie McCovey, who had the big hit in the seventh. They're both first basemen, or Mayberry and McCovey, are making big plays in this game. They're 3-for-3 in the seventh, eighth, and ninth inning to this point. Can McCovey make it 4-for-4? Here's the pitch, Willie McCovey in the bottom of the ninth. Another 32, back-to-back 32s. McCovey, it's a ground ball to first, and the Giants have snatched defeat from the jaws of victory here in San Francisco. Braves get a sweep. Oh, that's not good news at all. We are done here in San Francisco. A three-game sweep for the Braves. Campbell gets a save. He's got a walk and a K. Messersmith, 8 innings, 11 hits, gets a win. 11 hits and 4 runs. They were all earned. Walk 3, strikeout 5. The loser is going to be Randy Moffitt here. Moffitt gives up... Yeah, he gives up 2 unearned runs because the inning started with an error. Wow. So he gives up. I guess he's charged with a loss. Yeah, sorry about that. Lavelle does get charged. Those runners are charged to him. That's not going to be right in the Giant clubhouse, but there you go. Moffitt came in, gave up 2 hits and a K. And Lavelle gave up. He gave up no hits, but 2 runs, 2 unearned runs, and a walk. A strange line that is. No hits, 2 unearned runs, and a walk for Lavelle. Wow. And in 7 innings, Uria. Some questionable decisions by the Giants in this game. That's how the ball, that's how the cookie crumbles, as they say. 1019, 0109, 59411. 4-7-4-6. So let's see what this does year to date now. And a game 3. Giants get swept by the Braves. Not cool. Not cool, Giants. They're now 6-9, hitting 280 with a 390 ERA. Both of those are good. Hotlanta. Nice little run here, Braves. That could change the complexion of the National League East. Oh, well, they're 8-9, so they really needed that. They were 5-9 before that series started, so they get back into the middle of things. 8-9 are the Braves, hitting 299 with a 423 ERA. Let's see what the league looks like in the National League East. Oh, yep, Phillies. We were worried about this. Phillies are 11-4, but there are those Mets, 6-4, just 2.5 back. And the Braves got into the middle here. Marlins, still an expansion team. How about the Giants? Oh, yeah. National League West is very underachieving. Even the Dodgers are 4-6. Just a very lackluster division with the Astros holding the flag at 8-5. So that's it today from the 76-7-8-9 Carryover League. Hope you enjoyed the game. We'll see you again next time.